Or we're not. My version, of course. Going slow and making sure it's right the first time as we cinch it up fairly close. And then with tension, just drawing it down so it doesn't burn. Once I know it's in good, trim it in fairly close, but doesn't have to be super tight. Bind it down good enough so we don't get any slippage. And so I don't burn my hands. Connection. It's a double surgeon's loop. Lining it up the best way you can. Crosses just right. Medium on the first pull. Tighten on the tag. Tight on the main. Double over. Call an improved double surgeon's loop. As it crosses over, everything lines up. Medium. Tighten on the tag. Tighten on the main. Split the loops all the way out. Trim the tags, leaving a little bit of a trailer. Ready for fly lock. Complicated to know it, but in here, our biggest thing is consistency. A little bit bigger, so we just kind of carefully enlarge it using our fingers. Doesn't hurt anything. And then, easier to lay this down. through the opposite way that you do with a leader, because we're on the back end. Fly line goes through once, and a half twist, and go back again. See if you can see it. And it cinches down to that. And then we kind of make sure that's straight. And then bring it in a little bit tighter. And see how it lines up just like that. Never any pressure on the bottom of the loop, making it that much stronger. And I do this to less chance for a tangle. And I like to where it goes in the same direction, winding underneath the spool, from underneath the disc. I'll hand line this wide to make sure it doesn't get tangled up in the tools. Especially the scissors. And notice we swing it wide. Once we know it's bound, there, so there's no pressure, and then we do it medium instead of tight, so not to promote line movement. Finger tight, no tighter. Always leaving 10 to 12 inches of the fly line or leader hanging out.